بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد أي الهبة في الله. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us very, very beautiful advice. And it is from the advice of Nabuwwah, that prime, very, very important advice that has a whole Manhaj contained within it. It brings about immense fawaid and benefits for us if we understand it and we practice it in its entirety. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Usikum wa nafsi bi taqwallah." Or "Usikum bi taqwallah." Wa sam'i wa ta'a. Wa in 'abdin habashiyyan. Fa innakum man ya'ish minkum ba'di fa sayara ikhtilafan kathira. Fa 'alaykum bi sunnati wa sunnati al-khulafa' ar-rashidin al-mahdiyyin. عضوا عليها بالنواجد وإياكم محدثات الأمور فإن كل بدعة ضلالة. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I advise you to fear Allah and hear and obey those in authority over you, even if it was an Ethiopian slave. And whoever amongst you lives long will see many different kinds, will see lots of differing. So it is upon you to follow my sunnah and the sunnah of the rightly guided Khalifat and cling to it with your molar teeth and beware of newly invented matters, for every newly invented matter is a bid'ah. And every bid'ah is misguidance. Ahabatif Allah, we're going to bring about some of the fawaid of this prophetic advice, because it's so relevant for us now. Even though we've heard it countless times, we hear our ulama explain it, we've read it in the books of hadith, and it's used in lectures and so forth, but we can never get enough reminders. And that just reading this hadith has affirmed for me personally to try to strive and be better, be a better Muslim, clinging to the Sunnah and not getting weak when you're going to be attacked by many people who have different manahij, they have different methodologies. They're going to call you away from the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They're going to say, no, we have a new way of doing it. No, ISIS says do this, Boko Haram says do this, Al-Shabaab says do this, cut the head like this. They're going to have many different shortcuts. Ikhwan al-Muslimin says this, this group says this, the Sufis turn the lights off and make dhikr like this. These are all ways to take you away from the asl of your deen, usul al-deen, from understanding those fine principles that come from Kitabillah wa Sunnah to Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the madhab of the Salaf of this Ummah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I advise you to fear Allah, to have taqwa. Taqwa, habitif Allah, we said countless times, it is avoiding the muharramat, staying away from those things Allah has prohibited, and enjoining and doing those things which Allah has commanded. That's a concise definition of taqwa. And hear and obey the authorities over you. So this is hearing and obeying the Muslim rulers. So that rules out the protest, that rules out the revolutions, that rules out the coups, that rules out the other ways of trying to dispose of the leader and arguing and debating and attacking the honor of the leader and so forth. That doesn't mean the leaders don't make mistakes. That doesn't mean some of them aren't outside of the fold of Islam and some of them are in the fold of Islam. We're talking about the ones that are in the fold of Islam. That if they're in the fold of Islam, they have this haq over you. They have this right. Because the Prophet ﷺ said all throughout Sahih Muslim, you'll see countless ahadith. In one hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "As-sam'i wa ta'a ala mar'i al-muslim bima yuhibbu wa kariya wa kariya ma lam yu'mir bi ma'siyatin fi idha umira bi ma'siyatin fala sam'a wa la ta'a." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Hear and obey the authority." As-sam'i wa ta'a ala mar'i al-muslim bima yuhibbu wa kariya. In those things which you love and those things which you detest. As long as he doesn't command you with sinfulness to Allah. Because if he commands you with sinfulness to Allah, then there's no hearing and there's no obeying. So that means we don't hear and obey in the commands of ma'asiyah, of ma'asiyah. Not in all, that does not nullify his authority. Very important to understand that, to understand the correct understanding of that hadith and not the way of the mukhalifin from the takfiriyin and the khawarij and the neo-khawarij wa'iyadu billah min dalika. So the Prophet ﷺ said, hear them and hear and obey them. That isn't because we're on the payroll of someone, but Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, Muhammad ibn Abdullah salawatu rabbi wa salamu alayhi, said this all throughout tons of hadith. اسمع واطيع في أسرك ويسرك وأثرة عليك وإن أكل مالك وضرب ظهرك كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in another hadith, hear and obey the authority, even if he oppresses you and beats your back. وإن أكل مالك وضرب ظهرك, even if he takes your wealth and he beats your back, you still have to hear and obey him. And that which is obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That shows you Islam is about stability. It doesn't mean Islam accepts his oppression. He'll be called accountable. And you have a right to get your haq in that society by going through the proper channels, but not through rebellion, not through attacking, not through things that are going to cause rebellion and these things against the leader. That's just a haq Allah gave him. For example, if your parents have tremendous right. If your parent beats you, and he beats you even unjustly, that doesn't mean you defend yourself and beat your parents. Maybe they hit you one time unjustly. They made a mistake. That doesn't mean you defend yourself, you block it, you smack your parents in the face. وَعِيَذَا بِاللَّهِ مِنْ ذَلِكَ لَا. Those are rights Allah has given them. And rights that the Muslim authority has over you. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and whoever amongst you lives long will see lots of differing. And we see lots of differing, and it happened after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that there was tons of ikhtilaf. During the time of the Sahaba, it began that there was the Khawarij appeared, the Shia appeared, the Qadariya appeared, and then after them many other groups, the Jahmiyyah, the Mu'tazila, the Asha'ira, the Ashaariis that we see today, that is widespread throughout the Ummah, all of these sects, they began to appear. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, فَسَيَرَا اخْتَلَافٍ كَثِيرًا. He said, you will see many differences, a lot of different. Then he gave us a prescription. So it is upon you to follow my sunnah, and the sunnah of the rightly guided Khalifa, meaning the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Abu Bakr wa Umar wa Uthman wa Ali radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. So we love the Sahaba. That's from Islam. That's a key point of the Aqidah of Islam. The Aqidah of Ahl Sunnah wa Jama'ah is we love the Sahaba to Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. We don't speak about Muawiyah. We don't curse Abu Bakr and Umar. We don't make takfir of them. We don't make takfir of any of the Sahaba. We don't criticize and attack Uthman. Radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. La. Ahl Sunnah stops. And whatever sins and mistakes that they made, we believe they were forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that they were the people of Taqwa and Tawbah, and they were the best of this generation, the best of this Ummah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said this. He salawatu rabbi wa salamu alayhi said, khayran nas qarni thumma alladhina yalunuhum thumma alladhina yalunuhum. The best people It's my generation. Then dudes follow them. Then dudes follow them. The Prophet ﷺ said, and cling onto it with your molar teeth. So cling onto that sunnah with your molar teeth. I know people are going to attack you. People are going to say, I disagree with you. People are going to say, why are you talking about this one? People are going to say this. They're going to say that. But you have to stick to the madhhab. Stick to the manhaj. Stick to the methodology of the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ. That which is in accordance with Muhammad ﷺ, stick to it. Stick to it. But if you make a legitimate mistake, of course you have to correct it. Because the minhaj is correcting it. The minhaj is other than your mistake. Your mistake is your mistake. It has nothing to do with the madhab of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. It has nothing to do with the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you're practicing jihad wrong, like ISIS and Boko and all those other guys, then that's on you, that's on them. Those sins are on them for their evil and their wickedness and their brutality. It's on them, it's not upon the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's not upon Islam. Likewise, if you're making dhikr to Allah in a way that's ghayr mashroor, in a way that was not legislated by the Prophet ﷺ, turning off the lights, saying Allahu, Allahu, and dancing, and all these other things that have nothing to do with Islam, or are deviants from the asl of Islam, those things are not accepted. And those things are not an illustration of clinging to your molar teeth, to the sunnah. La, you're departing from the sunnah. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Man ahdatha fi amrina hadha ma laysa minhu fahuwa rad." Whoever deviates in this matter of ours will have it rejected. So those practices are rejected. A bid'ah is rejected. And then the Prophet ﷺ said, "And beware of newly invented matters, for every newly invented matter is a bid'ah, and every bid'ah is misguidance." And I think that's clear. So, yes, you will be attacked. Yes, people will try to persuade you with new argumentation. If you don't have the knowledge, stay out of the debates and cling to the sunnah. And stick with the ulama of Ahl Sunnah, especially the major ulama, the major scholars. I'm not talking about someone you're going to find in the West. I'm sorry, there's no major scholars, and I can say that with confidence. Yes, there are students of knowledge, mashallah. Yes, there are brothers who have knowledge that maybe is a sheikh in our communities. We have them, mashallah, coming from Egypt and from Somalia and many different countries. But most of the people have not reached the level where you're going to call them a great alim in the West. We haven't had that kind of tarbiyah yet. Maybe our children, maybe their children. The point being, alhamdulillah, stick with those people who are trustworthy, that are calling the kitabillah wa sunnah to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the understanding of the Salaf based on ilm and fiqh. So increase your knowledge so you have the tools to be able to distinguish between haqq and batil. And may Allah forgive me for anything that I said that was incorrect, and correct me. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all with guidance and forgive us all, bless us with ikhlas, with thabat. Ala sunnati nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika an ushrika bika wa ana a'lamu astaghfiruka liman a'lamu. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.